I created this monthly subscription tracker template in Excel to help me stay on top of my spending, track all of my billing due dates so I would never miss another renewal or due date. Managing subscriptions can get overwhelming. There's so many streaming services, software tools, entertainment subscriptions that we can sign up for, and all of these silently add up over time. I'm excited to share this subscription tracker template with you because it's been a huge help for me to help me reduce stress around managing subscriptions and help me identify areas where I can cut back. If you're looking to take control of your subscription spending, then this tracker is for you. It's available for purchase and I'll include a link in the description below. In this video, I'll walk you through all the features of the template, how to customize it for your needs, and you'll see how it can simplify your subscription management process, saving you time, money, and effort. When you purchase the template package, you'll get a macro-enabled Excel version that has a data entry form, making it easier and quicker to enter in all of your subscription data onto the tracker. But if you don't enable macros or want to use that, there's also a non-macro enabled Excel version that you'll get that will have the subscription tracker tab and the analysis tab. And then you'll also, if you don't use Microsoft Excel, there is a Google Sheets version that you'll get of the basic tracker. Let's take a look. In this subscription tracker template, the first one I'm going to show you is the macro-enabled version. And so on this one, you'll see a subscription tracker tab that contains the list where we're going to track all of our subscriptions. But in this macro-enabled version, we also have a subscription entry tab. And this is actually an Excel data entry form that lets us enter our subscription data quickly. We can hit submit and it will add that data onto our tracker tab. So this particular form, if you're going to use this sheet, you can open this up. And it's initially going to be locked, so it's protected so that you can select the first gray cell, which is the data entry cell for subscription information. And when you hit tab, it's going to go through each of those cells quickly and easily for you to enter all of your subscription data. Now, if you want to update anything like the category drop-down list, so right now we have a drop-down here with different categories, you can customize this. All you have to do is unprotect the sheet first. So on the home tab, just come up here under the cells area and click on format, drop down and select unprotect sheet. Now that's going to unprotect the sheet so that you can select anywhere. Go ahead and click on the category cell. Then you're going to go up to your data tab. Under the data tools, drop down where it says data validation. And then on the settings tab, we have our source field here, and this is where we have all of those drop-down list selections. So if you want to add something, just simply put a comma and add your next category. Or if you want to update these or rearrange them, you can. They'll show up in this order. And so when you're ready, you can just click OK. And then we can go and reprotect the sheet. Just go back to the home tab, click on format, go to protect sheet. Make sure that the box up here that says select unlocked cells is checked, as well as the last two options, which are edit objects and edit scenarios. Make sure those are checked and click OK. Now let's go ahead and enter in a new subscription. So I'm going to click on my cell for subscription and we're just going to start typing. I'm going to put Adobe CC, and then I'm going to tab over to the category, and I'm going to say this is a business category. If I just start typing B, my business category will pop up and I can just hit tab. So I don't have to hit the drop down selection. If I just start typing, it will automatically populate with my selection there. I can hit tab, and then I can type in a link if I want a hyperlink to show up on my tracker. And then any notes that I want to capture, maybe I want to capture my payment type of how I'm paying for this subscription, or any other notes that you want to capture. You can type in the date that you're going to start the subscription and the billing cycle. So this is a drop down. You're going to want to leave these values in here. I'm going to click annually for this one. And then I'm going to check the box since this one will auto renew every year. And then if I have a trial price, I can put the trial price and the trial price end date here to track that. So let's say I had an introductory price to begin with that they gave me, just as an example, and then that's going to end, and my regular price that I'm going to pay annually. When you do have a trial price, there will be an amount, the difference that you're going to pay will appear over here briefly. Once you hit submit, notice that everything gets cleared out and resets so that you can go ahead and enter in a new subscription. I'm going to click OK that my subscription data submitted successfully to this pop-up, and then I can enter in a new subscription. Now, if we go back over to the subscription tracker tab, notice that our new entry that we put in our data entry form has automatically been added to our table. Now this is being done, that submit button works based on some VBA code. So I'm going to show you that code and how it works just in case you do want to make any modifications or customizations to this tracker, you'll know how to update that VBA code. So if you come up to your developer tab and click on Visual Basic, you'll notice that there's a module in here and there's some VBA code. And what this says is that it's looking at, there are two tabs, the subscription entry tab, and it's going to add a row of data onto the subscription tracker into the table called subtrack. And so if we look at our Excel spreadsheet, if I click on the table here, and I go to table design, I've named that table subtract. So that's the name of my table up here. So if you happen to rename that table, just remember if you want that VBA code to work, you'll want to update that in the VBA code. And so then what it's doing is it's saying that it's going to look at the column number in the table. So column number one in the table, it's going to place the value that we enter in cell C5 of the data entry form, which is the subscription cell. So for example, if I come back over here, the subscription entry is in cell C5. So the macro is going to take that value that I placed there, and it's going to put that, add a new row and place that in the first column of that new table row. So that's what this code is saying. So if you do happen to make any modifications, if you add any columns of data and or modify anything that's on that data entry form, this is where you'll want to either add or change whatever you do edit in that VBA code. And then these cells are all of the gray data entry cells on our submission entry tab. And so these are going to clear out when we hit submit, and then it's going to give us that successful submission button that we click OK, and then we can add our next data entry form. All right, let me close out of the VBA. And if you are going to use the non-macro enabled version of the tracker, so it's going to look very similar. It's going to be the same tracker spreadsheet, but you won't see that data entry tab. And so the macros are not enabled on this file version in case you want to use that instead. And in order to use that, what you're going to do is simply enter in your new subscription data just below the table, and it will automatically add a new row to your table. So we would just simply start typing, and we would enter our date started and our billing cycle. And then notice that some of these dates are going to automatically populate for us. So anything on our tracker that's in a lighter blue column color, you will enter the data in those lighter blue columns. And then anything that's in a dark blue column header, those have formulas in those, so you won't want to touch those. You'll want to let those calculate automatically as you fill in the data. All right, let's jump back to the macro enabled version real quick. And I'm going to zoom in and we can take a closer look at this tracker. Okay, the first thing I want to show you is that we are using the today function in a couple places on this tracker. So for example, today's date does show up here. If for any reason you've left your workbook open and it's the current date and you're not seeing today's date as the current date, go ahead and hit F9 on your keyboard, or function F9 depending on your keyboard. That will refresh all the formulas in your workbook and it will update to today's date as the current date. You can also close and then reopen your workbook. That will refresh today's date as well. But one of the areas that we're using that today function is in the renewal date. So notice when we have the date that we started a subscription and the billing cycle interval, it's going to automatically populate the next renewal date. So this will be a formula that will always show you what your next due date or billing due date is on that subscription. And then we have a column here that's counting, kind of a countdown of the number of days between today's date and when that next billing due date or renewal date occurs. So this is going to be our countdown timer. So for example, if we want to sort this, we can click on the filter button here. We can say sort smallest to largest, and that's going to put our next upcoming subscription that's going to be due at the top. And notice that we have some color coding going on here, and this is through conditional. conditional formatting. So you can modify this if you want to. Right now I have this set up so that it will turn green if you are within 10 days of the billing due date. If you're within 3 to 5 days of the billing due date from today's date, it'll be yellow. And if you're within 2 days of the billing due date, it'll show up in red. So if you do want to modify that, all you have to do is come up to your home tab, go to conditional formatting, click on manage rules, and here's where we have those rules set up. So if you want to change those time frames of those alerts, you can through these formulas. You can double click and open them up and change the time frame where you want those to be alerted. And then you can change the formatting color if you want to. If you want those to be in a different fill color, you can just hit fill, select a different color, and click OK. So you would click OK, and if you did make any changes here, just click apply to apply those changes and then OK. But I'm going to go ahead and cancel. The next column over is our renewal month. And so this is looking at the billing interval and the next renewal date. And so that's going to populate a month over here that we'll be able to use in our slicer filters up here at the top. The trial price and trial period end, of course, is going to track the data if you need to for those elements of your subscription. And then here's where that new or regular price that you're going to regularly pay for that subscription, you're going to enter here in column K. If there is a price change between a trial price and the current price, it'll show you that price change over here. Then the next calculated column is going to be the regular annualized price, and this is going to automatically calculate. It's going to look at the billing cycle interval, and then it's going to look at the regular cost, and it's going to give you an annualized projection of what that subscription is going to cost you on a yearly basis. And so it doesn't mean that you've actually spent that money. It's not a budget tracker, but it's a projection of what you're going to spend annually based on the billing amount and the billing cycle. And so this will calculate for you automatically. And notice that on the tracker, we have this called out up here is going to be a sum total of that annualized cost. And then over here, we're going to take that estimated yearly spending cost divided by 12, and that's going to give us our estimated monthly spend. So it gives us an idea based on what we've signed up for and what the cost is on what we might be spending if we were to keep these subscriptions in place over a year's time. Now, on the macro-enabled version that we're looking at, the auto-renew is going to come across. If you check that box on the data entry form, it's going to come across as yes. If it's unchecked, it'll come across and appear as no. And then the link, of course, comes over, and then our notes come over. Now, just a quick note for you. If you do want to attach an image into your tracker here, maybe you have a receipt or a PDF or some sort of screenshot that you might want to track about that subscription, you can actually click on the cell in the notes area, come up to insert, pictures, place in cell, and then navigate from this device. You can browse and find the image that you might want to attach. And it'll place an image in that cell. And so if I select that cell, and then I click on this pop-up here, it'll place that image over the cell so I can take a look at it, and I can view that receipt. And when I'm ready, I can snap it back into that cell. I just have to make sure that the top left handle of that image is in the particular cell that I want it to live in, so it will snap back into the right place. And then I can click that button and it'll snap back in there and place that in the cell for me. So that's a way that you can track images and receipts and anything that you might want to in those notes. All right, let's go back up to the top and notice that we have some slicers up here at the top that we can use to filter our list. So the first one is by our renewal month. So as we have maybe different months or more data entered into our subscription tracker, we can look at, for example, every month. If we click on that button, it'll filter the list and we'll see the list of subscriptions that are renewing or that I pay for each month versus ones that maybe I just want to see in a particular upcoming month. I can select that month and it will filter that list. So as more months become available in that column, you'll see those as available items that you can filter on up here in your slicer. To clear the filters and add everything back, you simply hit clear filter, and then you have the multi-select button that you can choose multiple selections at once. So if I want to see just December and every month, I can deselect February and April, and then I'll see my every month and December items here. Then I can clear those filters and add everything back. So likewise, we have filters up here for the billing cycle. So if we want to see all of our annual subscriptions, we can click on annually and so forth. So we can always clear those or multi-select using these toggle buttons. Same thing with things that auto-renew. Maybe we want to see our list by any ones that automatically renew versus not. And then finally, we do have an analysis tab that does have two pivot tables with charts on here. And so the first chart is going to be some of the annualized price by subscription. And so what you'll want to do is click anywhere inside that pivot table, come up to pivot table analyze, and click on refresh. That'll refresh any new data that you've entered into your tracker. And then if you want to, this slicer is tied to this chart. So let's say we want to maybe take off the most expensive item and look at everything else on the list, we can select our multi-select here, and then we can deselect our most expensive item, and then it'll show the rest of those items. Likewise, we can compare two different subscriptions side by side here if you want to. Down here, there is a similar chart. It's a pie chart of the total annualized price by category. Now, if you don't have Microsoft Excel and you download the package, you will also get a Google Sheets version of the subscription tracker. So that one is going to look a little bit different. It's going to be out here in Google Sheets, and it's going to be set up like this where you can enter data into the table here. So we would just simply enter a new subscription. And then we have drop downs for the category. And then we'll enter in again in these light blue cells. You can enter the data in here. And in these dark blue column cells is where we have our formulas. So we'll go ahead and put a date in here and select our billing cycle. And then we'll automatically populate our data for us. We can put our price out here. And we can check whether it's an annual subscription or not, and put our link or notes. We do still have our filters up here at the top, so you can use those filters just like we do in the Excel version. So if you want to just look or take off certain items, say we just want to look at April, we'll click OK. That'll filter your list by just the criteria that you have up there. And if you do want to make any edits to your categories, all you have to do is come up to your data area. So let me go ahead and zoom in so you can see this a little better. Go up to data. Click on data validation. We want to select this area. It's column C where we have our categories. And here's where you can make some updates. You can add another category item. You can pick a color that you want that button to show up as. So you can edit that here. And when you're done, just click on done. And then you can close out. So this is the Google Sheets version. It doesn't have the data entry form and it doesn't have the analysis tab, but it is a basic tracker that you can use to track all of your subscriptions. If you have any questions about these templates, be sure and leave me a comment below and I'll do the best I can to help you out. You can subscribe to my channel and visit my website, SharonSmithHR.com, for more tools and resources. Thanks so much for watching and I'll see you next time.